Hello, hello, hello. I hope you are so great. Come on in here. I see you. I see you clicking in. Come on. I'm Deanna. If this is the first time that you're here, I just want to tell you, you're in the right place and I'm super excited to see you. And we're going to spend just a few minutes together before we head into our virtual service. Welcome to The Point Church. It's a great day to have a great day, y'all. I'm feeling good. It's my birthday weekend. Okay, Dee, okay. Turning 36, feeling feisty, feeling good, feeling like I'm finally feeling like an adult. It's taken 36 years. I'm finally feeling like an adult. You know, my kids are doing real good. My husband's great. I have a wonderful doggy. And so all those things matter. And I am starting to come into my own and really feel the love of Jesus, feeling very confident in my faith. Y'all know when you hit that spot, maybe you don't know, maybe you're not there yet. Let me tell you, you're in the right place. Keep plugging in, keep doing your thing, because maybe by the time you're 36, you'll finally feel like an adult. So I've had a great weekend celebrating, and I'm really glad to be here with you on my birthday weekend. I'm just going to keep on rocking on and celebrating with you and doing church together and celebrating God and worship and listening to a message. I'm just saying it's part of a great, great, great weekend for me. And if you are brand new today, a big welcome to you again. I'm really proud to see you here. Proud to see you plugging in. I have a challenge for you though. If you wouldn't mind, there is a connection card, a virtual connection card that I would love to see you check out really quick. It's just the pointchurch.net/connect. Fill that out. Let us know that it's your very first time here. We love connecting with you virtually. We have some online greeters that are standing by just to say hello and welcome you in. So if you feel comfortable right away, go ahead and fill that out for me. And so it's like a two-part challenge. Go ahead and like just choose to stick with us through this next it's about an hour, and I want to just help you feel encouraged. You know, I don't know how you came in to the service, if you just sort of were clicking through Facebook or maybe someone shared on their timeline, but I just want you to know that it's a God-cidental thing that you're here right now. And I really believe, I truly honestly believe, that God wants to meet you exactly where you are. So whether that's in your living room, maybe you're still in your comfy robe, maybe you're sitting at your kitchen counter, maybe you're just listening to me on the drive to somewhere, I want you to know God wants to meet you exactly where you are. So hang with us so that the Lord has an opportunity to work in your life today. So let us know, one, that you're here, and two, stick with us through the entire service. Now we do have a giant, great sermon series coming up called The Story of Jesus. And y'all, we did a Story of Jesus sermon last summer, and it was bomb.com to just go through an entire book of the Bible. And this year, this summer, we're doing the story of Jesus like 2.0 basically, but we're walking through the story of Mark. And so my goodness, is it a great time to invite someone to church, especially at the start of a series. So let them know that they're starting something new. Give them a challenge to just start attending through the whole sermon series, just to check out the Point Church for the summer. Give it a go. See what God does through the sermon and so through the different messages that our teaching pastors will bring, and see what God does through the book of Mark this summer. So be sure to check that out. It's on June 12th. And then we do have just a challenge for you, just to bring a friend, just bring somebody new. Now, if you are one of our online attenders only, it's super easy to invite someone. Just go ahead and share the sermon when we pop on live. And this way, all of your peeps can just like be invited to church with one click of a button. It's so easy to invite in that way. So heads up, that's coming up. Super excited to celebrate that with you guys. Now, if you are just clicking in with us, we're about to head into service. I love to see engagement. I love to see y'all just chatting it up. And you know what? Let's just do party poppers, because I celebrate all month long for my birthday. Yesterday was my big day, and I'm just still celebrating the life that God has given me. I'm so, so blessed to be here with you. So if you wouldn't mind, just like go ahead, put some party poppers on. Fine, let's go. Go birthday. Oh, I see the party poppers. It's my birthday. No holiday. Actually, it's a holiday. I totally treat it like a holiday. It's fine. All right, so stay engaged through the whole service. We're going to jump in just a few seconds. I'm praying God speaks to you today. Are y'all ready to go to church? All right, come on. Let's go.
Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are, wherever you're watching from. The important part is we're here to celebrate Jesus together. So come on, wherever you're at, put those hands together like this. We worship the God who was. We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors. He parted the raging sea. My God, He holds the victory. Here we go, come on.
There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be quiet.
Come on.
We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet.
Why? Come on.
We shout out your praise.
Saves. We sing to the God who always makes a way. 'Cause He hung up on that cross, then He rose up from that grave. My God, still rolling stones away.
There's joy in the house of the Lord.
Come on.
There's joy in the house of the Lord today.
We were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners, now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. The house of the Lord, sing praise. Sing with me, come on.
We were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners. Now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace.
Come on.
Let the house of the Lord sing praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today.
Yeah.
We won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord.
He won't. I've still got joy in chaos. I've got peace that makes no sense, so I won't be going under. No, I won't. I'm not held by my own strength, 'cause I build my life on Jesus. 'Cause He's never let me down. He's faithful in every season. So why would He fail now? He won't.
Hello, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Why am I screaming?
I don't know.
I love to scream.
You were so excited.
I am. You know why? Because it's getting warm out for good.
And you excited because it's my birthday yesterday.
It was your birthday yesterday.
And I turned 36.
36. You don't look a day over 26.
Thank you.
So happy birthday to Deanna. Hashtag happy birthday.
Happy
to
birthday. Deanna. You got a birthday coming up.
June 21st. I will be 52. I'm a long way from 36.
You got your cane?
Yeah, I do actually. I got a walker. Lined up.
It's so funny.
That's why I'm screaming.
I'm telling y'all, June birthdays are the best because we get presents every 6 months.
That's
we
right.
Get Christmas and our birthday.
That's right.
Yay.
Oh, thanks for us. Hashtag June babies.
Oh, man. Well, hey, and if you have a June birthday, put it in the comments. We want to say happy birthday to you. And a big welcome to those of you who are brand new for the very first time. This is your first experience here today. Big welcome.
Yes.
And we'd love to challenge you to a 3-point challenge. You can tell them what that's
called
if you want.
We say check us out 3 times, pray and listen, and just see if this is where God's asking you to grow spiritually, because we want to have God in charge of that. Not you, not I. Just pray and listen and see if that's it. And also give our greeters a chance to greet you. Just say, hey, I'm first time here, second time here, third time here.
Yeah.
And they're there to make you feel comfortable. So they will say hi back.
They're awesome.
And see how they are.
They're
we have
awesome.
A great group.
They're
great
awesome. Group. And then also, if you feel comfortable right away, we'd love to be able to pray with you through this week.
Yes.
We do have a section on that, thepointchurch.net/connect, where you can share a prayer request or even take some next steps if you're ready, whether you want to learn about plugging in through volunteering or grow groups or even how to get baptized. So you can do that on the same
speaking
spot.
Speaking of which, we're getting having baptism coming up soon. So
if
you're close enough and you want to get baptized, get with us.
Yes.
Come on in. We'll do it here when we do that. So it's a huge celebration in-house. So
absolutely.
If you're close enough and you want to get baptized, come see us.
Absolutely. Now, we also are starting a brand new series coming up. And so invite a friend for this new series, The Story of
Jesus.
We're going to be diving through the book of Mark. It's going to be awesome.
Yes.
But you know what? Some people are just waiting to be invited. Some people just want to be asked. And so I'm just giving you the power. If you needed permission, I'm giving you permission now. So is Todd.
Yeah. Like I'm waiting to be asked to lunch.
Go ahead. We give you permission.
That's
it's
right.
Fine.
So
invite somebody to church. And it's very easy. For those of you who are online attenders only, just click the share button and pop that bad boy on your feed. And then we also have all of our content on demand as well. So you can also share it from Facebook and YouTube. So it makes it easy. But invite someone to church. The Story of Jesus coming up very soon.
Now we got the catch up with Caleb.
Catch up
with Caleb.
Kick.
We really need to get ketchup
packets.
We need to get mustard and ketchup outfits.
Next week. We're doing it.
Something.
Okay, here we go.
Hello, Point Church. Caleb Kimball here on behalf of the board at The Point. I want to update you on the search process for our next lead pastor. As many of you know, God has led our founding pastor, Ray, to retire. And just as God has led Ray to start the church, we are confident that God is preparing a new lead pastor that will help us further advance our mission of helping people find and follow Jesus. Now, tonight, our pastoral search team, made up of 11 church representatives, they'll meet again and listen to presentations from a select group of search firms. Our hope, if everything goes well, will be that the search team will identify and select their top choice of a search firm that best fits our needs. Now remember, church, we don't want to rush this process. Once the search firm is selected, then we'll begin a deep dive into all the unique aspects that makes the Point Church special, that makes the Point Church feel like, well, home. That information, it'll be critical in the discovery process of a new lead pastor that fits our values right here at the Point. Our board, we greatly value transparency and communication back to you, so we'll report back to you next week about where God leads us as you continue to pray. Thank you, and God bless.
Yes, thank you so much, Caleb. You are awesome. Do you want to pray a song?
I sure will.
All right,
hey, God, thank you so much, Lord, for this day. And as we hear your word and glorify you and through song and now through word, and as we come together to do it, just may we hear you. I know that there's somebody here or many people here that need to see you, need to hear you. I pray, Lord, that you speak to them in a mighty way, that they would turn their life over to you, that their eternity would start today.
Yeah.
It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Have you ever been so single-minded that you never could imagine it any other way? Now, have you ever talked to someone who owns a Ford truck? And no other vehicle to them compares to the power and the awesomeness of Ford. But then you go and talk to a Chevy truck owner and they say the same thing. But how can that be? How can two people have the same opinion about two very different brands? Hey, how about this one? Apple or Android? We all know that there are people who still to this day believe an Android is better than an iPhone. They will talk about the fact that you're just buying onto the system of iPhone, but Androids are much better, and vice versa. See, us Apple users who are better for it, we feel that we're in the right, that we have the right phone, and all we want is for that group chat to be all blue bubbles so that we don't have to deal with those annoying green bubbles. Now, when I was growing up, I never thought to question how I washed my hair. But one day in high school, might I add, I'm reading the shampoo bottle instructions on the back, and I realized that I had gotten it wrong, that the rest of the world was using shampoo and then conditioner. See, for years, I had been conditioning my hair and then shampooing it. And now why I had such dry hair, it began to make sense. See, my mind was opened up to a whole new idea of how things were done, and my mind was changed the second I realized that my hair would be a lot healthier and happy if I shampooed and then conditioned. Now, let's play a fun game together, okay? I'm going to show you a picture, and what I want you to do in the comments is you're going to tell me how you would pronounce what's on the picture. Okay. All right. First up, is this a pecan or is this a pecan? Okay. What do you guys think? What do you think? Okay. Second, is this a caramel or is this a caramel? All right. How about this third? Is this a euro or is this a gyro? All right. How about this one? Is this a coupon or is this a coupon? And lastly, probably the biggest one of them all, is this a GIF? Or is this a GIF? Now, what I'm saying here is I want us to understand we all have preferences or ways we view things. But what we're going to talk about today is how we can move past our single-mindedness and become peacemakers in life, not peacefakers. See, I believe that often our single-mindedness in life can cause some of the biggest wars in life. Wars like political views, parenting preferences, social media, COVID, doing it the old way versus the new, or how important faith is to your family. Things like careers, style of music, clothing, movies, and so many other things we can argue about for time and time again. But what we must recognize is that there is an enemy who is joyful that we can become so caught up in these differences in life. See, the more we disagree, the less gets done for God. And so division in opinion is one of the greatest tools Satan uses in life. So when we are peacemakers, we declare we want peace, but only if it aligns with our agenda or our preferences. See, peacemakers, they disregard what Scripture says and they begin to create their own rules for when I keep peace and when I don't, when I fight and when I don't, when I post or comment and when I don't. Today, we're going to learn how to stop being peacemakers, stop having preferences that cause division, and learn how to become a peacemaker from Jesus Christ himself. See, Matthew chapter 5, verse 9, it says, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God." Romans chapter 4, verse 9 says, "Let us therefore make every effort to do what leads to peace and to mutual edification." I think it's safe to say we're called to make peace whenever we can. So let's see what principles Jesus uses to be a peacemaker in Matthew chapter 19, verses 16 to 22. Here's what it says. "Just then, a man came up to Jesus and asked, 'Teacher, what good thing must I do to get eternal life?' Jesus said, 'Why do you ask me what is good? There is only one who is good. If you want to enter life, keep the commandments.' 'Which ones?' he inquired. And Jesus replied, 'You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not give false testimony. Honor your father and mother and love your neighbor as yourself.' 'All these I have kept,' the young man said. 'What do I still lack?'" Well, he might lack a little humility. But beyond that, this is a really interesting story and interaction with Jesus. we see a man approaching Jesus, wanting to know how to receive eternal life, how to fill the hole that is missing from within him. Jesus then asks an important question to the rich young ruler. Why do you ask me what is good? See, he's wanting to see if this young man is acknowledging Jesus as God. Jesus then mentions the commandments, and not for the reason we might think. Jesus did not introduce the commandments to show the young man how to be saved, but to show him that he needed to be saved. So Jesus teaches us point one, peacemakers don't accuse, they inquire. See, peacemakers look to solve the problem, and you can only help once you've collected all the information you need. It makes me think of a video game called Among Us. This game, it's a little outdated, but the whole point of the game was to discover who the imposter was amongst a major group of people. And you'd put on your detective hat and try and discover who had done it. But most times you just ended up accusing random people based off of wrong assumptions or false information. And see, when we miss the little things and choose not to ask the important questions for clarity and understanding, we will accuse the wrong person. We will be peace fakers. So this is why peacemakers don't accuse, they inquire. If you notice, Jesus is saying very little right now. All he's doing is making and clarifying, gathering an understanding of the man before him. Let's read on in verse 21. Jesus answered, if you want to be perfect, go, sell your possessions and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Now, Jesus shares with the man, not in a hurtful way, not in a mean way, but in a graceful way, what he needs to do to actually have eternal life. What Jesus didn't say was, I know you're lying, nobody's perfect, or I can't believe you actually think you've kept all the commandments, or you're an idiot to believe that you have done all these things right. No. Jesus addresses the rich young man in a way that restores him, in a way that offers him an answer to the question he is seeking. See, our second point, peacemakers, they don't win, they restore. We must realize that life isn't about being the one who's right. Because if being right is just going to turn people away from Christ, what good does it serve? See, think of it this way. When you're in a fight with your husband, your wife, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your mom, or your dad, what is the goal? What do you hope is the end result of that fight? Now, I often get caught up in winning so much that I become a Mr. Right with all the answers, and I turn everything back on my wife. But the truth is that we need to restore, not win. We need to fight to make things better, not worse. We must lay aside the desire to be right and put on the desire to restore. Let's continue reading. He says, then come, follow me. And when the young man heard this, he went away sad because he had great wealth. Now, what happens is we often read this and say, this is the truth about money for everyone. But we must realize this was a singular personal issue that Jesus was trying to address in the rich young ruler. And there are many men and women who hold their money in the right place in their life, and they don't choose their wealth over God. But it leads us to such an important idea. It's that we cannot serve two masters, only one. And God makes that clear to the rich young ruler by challenging him to give up the other master in his life. And so what in your life is a master over you? What else are you holding on to in your life that God is asking you to get rid of, to sell, to be free of? Is it addiction? Whether that be addiction of pornography, adultery, alcohol, drugs, or so many other addictions. Is it wealth like the young rich ruler? Are you serving the desire to make more money over the calling God has put on your life? Is it image? Is it the need to look your best, to be your best, to have influence on socials, and to be seen as someone who has no faults? Is it politics? The desire to be so caught up in what people decide for our country over what God does regardless? Is it the need to be right, never considering someone else and how it might make them feel? Now let me ask you this. If you were to look at your life today, what you have, what you do, what you own, the status that you hold, Would you be willing to give it all away for God? Would you be willing to let go of the things God is asking you to let go of? See, this is what Jesus is challenging the rich young ruler to do. And sadly, he chooses the wrong master at the end of this story. What I want us to realize is that point three, peacemakers don't judge, they invite. See, just like Jesus invited the rich young ruler to come and follow him, so we must invite people into a real conversation that helps them make a decision. We invite them to what we believe and know to be the best, but the decision is still theirs to make. And this makes me think of my year-old daughter who loves raspberries. She'll eat a whole container of raspberries in probably like 2 to 3 meals if we let her. But you know what I have tried to do that means she will eat 0 raspberries? See, when she isn't hungry, I will try and put a berry in her mouth. And she will shake her head. She's learning how to say no. She'll shove me away because she doesn't want me to force food at her. Just like nobody wants you to force the gospel at them. See, Jesus showed us that it works a lot better to just lay it down in front of them and let them make the decision. And it's so silly what a difference that makes for my daughter. See, she will look at the berries and joyfully pick one up and continue to eat them. And so I encourage you, in your desires for others to hear the truth of God's word, let's not force it at them, rather. Let's be peacemakers, not peace fakers. Let's focus more on a relationship than a script. Let's think like Jesus did. So what do peacemakers do? Well, peacemakers, they don't accuse, they inquire. See, we need to lay down accusations and just listen to people and their stories. 2, peacemakers don't win, they restore. Let's not forget that winning isn't everything in life. It's not a competition or a race, it's a relationship. Let us put the time into building it and look for ways to restore rather than just to be right. 3, peacemakers, we don't judge, we invite. We've got to be loving about how we share the truth of a loving God to others. Let God lead you. Let him guide you on what is edifying and helpful. And so, church, I challenge you this week, who do you serve? Is it God, or is God trying to pull you away from something that can't provide eternal life, that can't provide peace in the storm, that can't be there for whenever you need someone, that can't satisfy you today? See, I know who my master is. His name is Jesus, God, Yahweh. And he loves me, he accepts me, and he works in me. But who is your master? Would you guys pray with me? God, I feel that we all go through life and we all struggle with the reality that, man, there's so many things that are pulling us. There's so many things that are calling for us to be good or right or to succeed or to feel like we've got to be what other people want us to be. But God, I know something so important and so true. It's the fact that you take us as we are. And so God, I ask for people right now, right today, listening to this, God, that you would do a work in their lives. That they would say, God, I am giving up my old master because I want to serve someone who loves me. I want to serve someone who provides for me. I want to serve someone who has a future for me, who has an eternity for me. And so, God, we ask you to challenge our hearts. We ask you to prepare our hearts to give up whatever master we might be serving in our lives to serve you, God. Lord, I know that I struggle with things that pull me over and over again in life, but God, my focus should always be on you. And so I pray right now for people listening to this, for people hearing this, that they would know there is nothing that compares to what you provide, God. You can search years and you'll never find the peace that you provide, God. And so I pray for people right now as they feel a calling, as they feel a prompt to say, God, I want you in my life. Say hashtag Jesus. Say, I want you to be the ruler of my life. No more of these other masters. I want you, God. Thank you for who you are and what you did on the cross for us. In your wonderful and powerful name. Amen.
Amen, Noah. I love it so much. Don't be a peace faker. Be a peacemaker. That's super cute. I feel like we need some hand signals. I don't know, like peacefaker, peacefaker like this. I don't know. I'm not cool enough to make hand signals. It's fine. I'm really proud of you. I'm so glad that you're speaking into us today. Thank you so much for your words and your wisdom and allowing God to just speak to us through you. Love you so much. And go ahead, just praise God in the chat for Noah. He's an awesome children's or a youth pastor for our folks. And my daughter loves him so much. We so appreciate you, Noah. It's just great having you. So make sure that you're plugging in with us. Now, if you are brand new and you've taken my challenge at the start of this service to stick with us through the whole sermon, I'm just super proud of you. I'm really, really glad that you did it. Go ahead, let us know. If you haven't let us know yet, let us know that you're brand new so that we can connect with you. We love, love, love connecting with our new folks. Now you can do that at thepointchurch.net/connect, okay? Also, if you want to go ahead and if you want to partner with The Point Church through giving, you can do so a couple ways. Now, heads up, new folks, this point is not for you. This is for those of us who have decided to partner with The Point Church. We would not invite you to dinner and expect you to pay the bill, okay? So hear me on that. Just hang tight for me for just a second. If you want to go ahead and partner with The Point Church financially, you can always do so through our website, thepointchurch.net/give. And on that website platform, you're able to give by credit or debit. You can also do a text to give option at the number below. Super easy and very fast way to just give, send a text, it's done. Also, we also have a live in-person services at 9, 10, 15, and 11:30. So if you're in-house and you wanna drop a gift on your way out the door, that works as well. All those ways are amazing and fabulous, and we so appreciate you. We are not able to carry out the mission of helping people find and follow Jesus without you. So thank you so much for allowing God to work through you week in and week out. Now, be sure to catch all of anything that Noah just talked about or any of our other sermons throughout this series on YouTube or on Facebook. We have it all readily available for you on demand. You can do a rewatch, you can send it to your friends, you can do all kinds of things, and be sure to engage with us there. We love the engagement through the week as well. So I'll see you guys next time.